Here's today's proverb. It comes from Proverbs 17, verses 27 and 28. The one who has knowledge uses words with restraint, and whoever has understanding is even-tempered. Even fools are thought wise if they keep silent, and discerning if they hold their tongues. Now, ultimately, I am more fool than wise most of the time. From time to time, I find a way to maybe make people think that I'm more wise than fool, but eventually, my mouth usually lets me down. Have you ever been in the middle of a conversation and you can feel yourself thinking, I should shut my mouth? Why do words keep coming out? Why am I still talking? It's never a fun thing to have that going off in your head. I wish I could say with certainty that I always use restraint with my words. I wish I could say with certainty that I'm always even-tempered. But it's just not the case. I remember one time when I pinched my finger under a door and a word came out of my mouth that I'm not proud to admit, and my nephew was like a foot away from me. There have been days when my wife comes home from work and I've been at home all day with the kids, and thankfully that only happens usually about one day a week. But one of these days, my girls, they tell my wife, yeah, daddy was frustrated all day. He just kept saying, why are you guys are just driving me nuts. And it's true, I just don't always pass the grade with my temper. And my guess is that when you read the above verses in Proverbs, you probably have the same thought that goes through your head. Even my wife, the most gentle and loving person that I know, has seen motherhood wear on her patience at times. She also has to deal with a short temper from time to time. It's what we do as humans. So are we all just fools? In the moments that when we actually hold our tongues, are we displaying who we are at our core? Or is that an outlier? In New Testament scripture, it makes the case that we really are fools at our core, but that God chooses to use the foolish to shame the wise. It talks about that in 1 Corinthians. Could it be that Jesus becomes my wisdom in the very midst of my own foolishness? Paul writes in Titus chapter 3, at one time you too were foolish, disobedient, deceived, and enslaved by all kinds of passions and pleasures. We lived in malice and envy, being hated and hating one another. But when the kindness and love of God our Savior appeared, He saved us, not because of righteous things we had done, but because of His mercy. Jesus' mercy saves us from our own foolishness. He truly becomes our wisdom. Every day that I live in Christ and submit myself to Him, I become less fool and more wise. Now, I'll never be fully there until the day that I see Him face to face. 1 John 3:2 says that, but I long to be as close to wise as I can every day. Acting or speaking foolishly does not make me a fool, though, in God's eyes any longer. Because I have Jesus, today I am seen by God as wise because I'm rooted in Christ, who's the author and giver of all good things. He is my wisdom. Even in my foolishness, I am wise in Him. Today, remember that because of Jesus, you are no longer a fool. You're wise because your wisdom comes from a place that isn't you. It comes from Jesus. He has put a piece of Himself in you by giving you the Holy Spirit. He's given you His wisdom. Don't forget that today. Let's pray together. Lord, I thank You so much that You give us wisdom. We don't have it on our own a lot of the time. We act foolishly. We talk foolishly. God, we give over our foolishness to You and we ask, fill us with Your wisdom. Something that we can't do on our own. We need a supernatural gift of wisdom from You, and we ask for it today in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, thanks, everybody. Hope you guys have a great week. We'll see you next time.